The Roto Brush is personally one of my favorite tools for daily care. We use it on show day as well, but the value comes using it daily at home and preparing for a show. We like to use it obviously when they're dry. So after we wash and dry them, we go back and we'll roto brush them. And what it does is you're training that hair for show day. You're getting the dirt and dandruff off of their hide and you're helping promote hair growth. I think one thing that you can really, using this every day, you can change your program. I think nowadays leg hair and stuff so important, and you just help yourself when you actually get to show day. The way we use it, and there's a couple things that I'd note, is one of the most important things is what Brock's doing is holding that tail. It can be very dangerous for both you and the calf if that tail gets wrapped up in this. The other thing I like is the cordless roto brush for a couple reasons. You have variable speeds. This can get really hot when you're running it, and you can adjust your speed down where it goes slower and you're not going as fast. And the other thing I like, obviously just the cordless aspect, you just got a lot less that can get tangled up. It's really important to make sure that your roto brush is always turning in an upward fashion. So when we start on this leg, we want to make sure that brush is turning so all the hair is rotating up, and then you can turn it as well to make sure it's going on the front of the leg, it's always going up. Now, the first time you use this on a calf, they may not like the noise, so you want to make sure you maybe start on a front leg or just approach them real soft and gentle and make sure maybe somebody's scratching them. As you get to using it on a daily basis, they get used to it. They really like it. It's kind of got a therapeutic massaging feel to it, and they really enjoy it. But the first time you do it, just make sure you're a little careful. You can see that's getting a lot of the dandruff and stuff out of the hide, and that's really important to keep that clean to promote hair growth. The other thing I tell you is we always start going up, and then we like to finish going back down. It just kind of separates that hair on the way back down. So we're going to stay kind of at the hock and work our way down. We don't want to get up in this body hair where it's longer. We can start seeing it kind of tangle up and pull hair out around the bolt here. We want to stay away from that long stuff. So we've got it rotating up, and then we finish down. Then we're going to switch directions on the front of the leg so it's again going up. And then finishing back down. Now you can see we've brought a lot of dirt and dandruff to the surface here after using the roto brush. We're gonna then take a comb and a blower and blow that and separate that hair back out, because it's kind of starts to tangle it up a little bit, and we need to get that dirt and dandruff back out of them.
No.